Louisiana Congressman Steve Scalise, the House Republican whip, returned to the Capitol today for the first time since he was gravely wounded in an assassination attempt more than 3 months ago. Our Nora O'Donnell was there when Speaker Ryan broke down in tears as he welcomed Scalise back. Nora's story about his battle back is coming up Sunday on 60 Minutes. But tonight, Chief Congressional Correspondent Nancy Cordes has the story of the emotional homecoming.
It was a triumphant moment for Scalise and an emotional one for his colleagues. As the House Majority Whip walked on his own into the House chamber.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Louisiana seek recognition?
To speak out of order, Mr. Speaker.
Scalise started by thanking the heroes who saved his life.
David, you are my hero.
Capitol Police officers David Bailey and Crystal Griner.
When I was laying there, not long after the first couple of shots were fired, I could hear a different caliber of weapon. And that told me that they had immediately engaged the shooter. And let me tell you, if they didn't act so quickly, and even after being shot both themselves, continued to engage the shooter and ultimately got him down, which not only saved my life, but saved the life of a lot of other people that are here in this chamber today.
Luckily, he said, one of those people was Ohio Congressman Brad Wenstrup, a doctor and former Army medic.
Who would have thought that God would have put Brad out there on that field with me, because the tourniquet he applied, many will tell you, saved my life so that I could actually make it to the hospital in time with all the blood loss. So Brad, where are you at?
Right down front.
Scalise has had to relearn how to walk.
How are you feeling physically?
I feel great. Obviously, I have a lot of work to go on rehab.
In an interview to air this Sunday on 60 Minutes, he told Nora O'Donnell he was unconscious for most of the first 4 days.
I found out later just how much damage was done internally. You know, I mean, my femur was shattered. The hip and pelvis had serious damage where the bullet went through and, you know, did some damage to areas that had to be shored up with steel plates, and they did a phenomenal job of rebuilding, you know, kind of the rebuilding Humpty Dumpty. I mean, there were there was a lot of damage inside that that had to get fixed.
They put you back together again.
They put me back together again.
Scalise has spent the past 3 months first in the hospital, then in an inpatient rehab center. He is now back to work, but he's still going to be spending a lot of time at an outpatient facility working to regain his strength and mobility. Anthony?
So great to see the congressman back, Nancy. Thank you. You can see Nora O'Donnell's interview with Congressman Scalise this Sunday on 60 Minutes and first thing tomorrow on CBS This Morning.